Boom! Yes, quarantine made me do this. It's a perfect lockdown brownies made using just four ingredients. You won't believe this turns out to be so chewy, so fudgy, moist that you won't miss your actual real chocolate brownies. I loved it, and I'm sure you all will love it too. No oven, no eggs, no chocolate, no cocoa powder, no butter, oil, absolutely no flour. Somebody stop me from having the next bite, please. So let us start by preheating our cooker, for which I'm placing a cooker and a trivet inside on high flame here. You can also switch on your oven at 180 degrees Celsius if you would like to bake this in an oven. Instead of a cooker, of course, a kadai can also be used. Use whatever you have handy. This is so easy. And then let us also grease our baking pan in which we'll be baking this. Ideally, for making brownies, we use a square pan, but I didn't have one that would fit inside my cooker. If you have one, then definitely go ahead and use that. Or else simply use a round pan like I did. Grease it with butter first and then line it with a parchment paper so that it is easier to transfer. You will know when we bake the cake, I mean, sorry, the brownie. So line it with the parchment paper, trim off the excess and set it aside. All our prep work is now done. Let's get on to make our brownie batter, for which we will need some chocolate cookies. I'm using the bourbon biscuits. You can use Oreos or any chocolate cookies that is easily available to you. So just grind it or pulse it in your mixer first and then add in the milk and our secret ingredient, which is going to make this brownie taste exactly like a regular chocolate brownie, and that is condensed milk. So no fancy equipments, no spatula, nothing. Just a mixer is good enough for making this batter. So once you have added all the ingredients, pulse it again to get it into a batter-like consistency. And finally, add in the baking powder and pulse that too. Give it a quick mix, pour it into your cake pan, level it off. Tap it to remove any excess air bubbles, and it's time to bake. And then place this in your preheated cooker and bake it for 30 to 45 minutes until a skewer inserted in the center comes out with some fine crumbs attached to it. If you are baking it in an oven, it would take around 25 minutes, and in a cooker or a kadhai, it would take anywhere between 30 to 45 minutes. Then allow it to cool in the pan itself for another 5 minutes, then transfer to a wire rack and cool completely. Once cooled, you can simply cut it into slices and enjoy as it is, or you can take it a step ahead and add in any favorite chocolate sauce of yours. A simple chocolate sauce, a Nutella or a chocolate ganache, anything would be fine. Or simply cut it into slices, just like I said. I'm adding in some dark chocolate ganache as well as some white chocolate ganache to give it the swirl effect. Just because I was in a mood to decorate it, nothing else. It tastes good on its own as it is, trust me. So yeah, go ahead and decorate the way you like it. This is how I did mine. To make the swirled effect on top, just before the dark chocolate sets, add in the white chocolate ganache and then at random places, and then using a skewer, just swirl around. Make sure not to go way too much or else you would end up mixing both the colors. I also wanted to let you guys know that I have not added any salt while baking in the cooker. If you like, you can add some salt to the base and reuse that salt whenever you bake it in a cooker. The next thing, I also didn't add the whistle and the ring, so take care of that too. And I know there's a lot of instructions, right? Last thing, I wanted to let you guys know that I will be going live on Instagram this Saturday to make sourdough culture or starter from scratch. So let's bake along, and I would love if you all could join too. I will leave a link in the description box and comments, so please do join. And that's it for today. I'll see you soon with next one. Until then, this is Sushma signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.